The most important, I don't care what you've got for engine, I don't care what you got for transmission, I don't care whose chassis you buy, I don't care if you build it yourself or if you buy it from somebody. This area right here needs to be addressed, okay? You need to take care of the driver's compartment. And I see time after time after time after time, guys getting in these cars and they look like a damn sausage crammed in there because they're so oversized for the area that they've got to sit in. And they're all jammed up in there. The steering wheel's in the wrong place. The pedals are in the wrong place. The seat's in the wrong place. But they're just putting up with it because they don't think it's that big of a deal. But when this thing's rolling on its side 7 or 8 times down on the big end of the racetrack, it becomes a big deal. Fix this area before you get to that point. All right, guys, Tim McCamus back out in the shop for some more technical videos. I want to take a minute to talk to you about this driver's seating area of the car. So we've touched on this a lot. We, in our build series, we did some driver fitment and we did some measurements and showed you how some clearances are set up here. But we wanted to talk a little bit more detail about basically your body clearance here in this area. You know, if the car is upright going down the racetrack and everything's good, it's not a problem. It's just when things go bad, that's when this stuff becomes important. If you're sliding on your roof or your barrel rolling over the guardrail or whatever other instance you can get yourself into, it's important to pay attention to this. So if you're building a car from scratch now, if you're starting on a new car or if you're in the process of mounting the seat, or even if you've got an existing car that has the seat already mounted and it's just not right, fix it. Because it's not something that you just put up with. You need to deal with that and fix the problem. And I know you might say, oh, I don't want to cut the seat out and change anything, but you know, a little bit of work there and a little bit of chassis paint is much better than being in traction or having your neck broke or your back broke or whatever else is going to get hurt while you're involved in an accident. But so I want to touch on a couple of things here. And one of the issues with these type of chassis is that, you know, over the years, and they've getting lower and lower and lower and lower and smaller, and the drivers keep getting bigger. So we got a issue with the one size outdoing the other. So the cars are getting lower, the roof lines are getting shorter to accommodate the aerodynamics to make them a little slicker and make them move through the air better. But the downside to that is reduced area for the driver. The area for the driver should be the most important aspect of building the chassis. It shouldn't be build the car to perform through the air the best and make it the, let's say, the chassis design and the aerodynamics of the car your primary function, but your driver's crammed in there like 10 pounds of shit in a 5-pound bag. So let's get some clearance in there. So we got a given dimension from the bottom of the chassis to the top of the main hoop, and we want to get as much in there as we can. So if we've got a big driver here, and some drivers are big, some of them aren't that big, but they're proportioned weird, you know, like maybe they've got shorter legs and a bigger torso, you know, so that makes the distance from their ass to their head longer than maybe a guy that might be taller than them. So you gotta make sure that you got plenty of room here so that you can't have your helmet jammed up against the chassis and your ass crammed onto the floor. If you take a hard impact, all that energy is gonna be transferred right into your spine, your neck, your head, all that stuff is gonna get compressed, okay? It's important to concentrate on that issue. So, you know, the seats, if you're gonna use one of these carbon bucket seats, I mean, we make these seats and we sell them. I hate these things, okay? Because I believe there's better seats out there. And we use the Racetech and the Momo seat. They're two very, very good seats. They're excellent build. They're FIA certified. They're just really high quality seats. They fit perfect. If you ever drive a car with a Racetech or a Momo seat in it, you will never sit in one of these again. So regardless, sometimes you have to do that, okay? Sometimes you have, maybe you already have a carbon bucket in there. These seats are functionable if they're done right, if they've got the right support and they've got the right pour in and they've got the right head padding, they got all the other bullshit in place, they will do a decent job. In my opinion, they don't do nearly as good a job as a seat that's designed for a race car. So you take a Momo or a Racetech seat, you know, you've got a nice tight head surround, you've got support for your shoulders, support for your rib cage, support for your hips and legs right in here, so you fit in the seat comfortably. They don't have a pour-in, but the seat foam in there forms around you when you sit in the seat, and when you put the belts on, they fit you perfectly. There's inserts that you can change in here to make it fit you just right. But you still have to have room. You can't fit one of those seats in there and have your head jammed up against the top of the chassis. It's not doing any good. You know, ideally, it'd be nice if we could have 3 inches over every helmet from to the closest tube. You just can't do that in these cars. I mean, even for a small driver, it's hard to get that much room. But, you know, somebody like me, I'm not even quite 5'9". I mean, I got room, you know, but it's not very common to have that small of a driver. So most guys are kind of jammed up in there. So we can move the seat down lower, but you can't move the seat down and sit right on the bottom of this thing. You've got to give yourself some room for some absorbent padding, something that's going to take the impact, something like some ISP padding, the pour-in seat, the foam that's going to be energy absorbing. That needs to be under your ass. You don't need to be sitting down here on a quarter inch piece of foam. You might as well not be sitting on anything. If you're going to set the seat down and get it to the lowest point, you're going to need to have a couple tubes under there to protect the bottom of the seat. Now, there are currently some rule changes being kind of bannered around about actually putting a thicker plate under there, but that's not quite ready yet. So currently the procedure is to have a couple tubes under there to protect the bottom of the seat, because you can only get it down so low. You know, you can't get the seat dragging the racetrack, so you can only get it so low in the race car, and then you still have the confines of the body and chassis. So this tube here, you know, I see some of these cars where this funny car cage tube is mounted back here, where there's no way for your helmet to fit in there. Now, these tubes we just tacked in for this illustration because we don't have the body setting on here now, so we don't know exactly where these are going to be. But this is 3/4 058, and that's going to be fit up here right under the roof line, and the roof line is going to be tight back here. So these are going to get cut down, but they're still going to look similar to this. But that's going to give us, we can't put nothing up here. The rules will allow to put a flat strip of 3/4 4130 up here, 3/4 wide by 090, which really all it does is kind of retain your head from popping out of the top. It doesn't give you a lot of support. You know, some of these rules have been around for a while, and there's a lot of focus being put on this area right now to make this better. So there's a lot of things going on here, but if the car you're currently in, if you get in it and your helmet is rubbing on the chassis on the top, you have to fix that. We'll help you with anything that you need, any information you need. If you're going to use a carbon seat, we'll tell you how to mount it. We've got instructions. We've got tons of videos on this stuff. But make yourself room. There's ways to make room. You know, if you need a little more room, you could slide the butt of the seat slightly forward. You don't want to get it too far forward, because then your back is not straight. Your back is bent, you know, but you can't just scoot your butt forward in the seat and not have any support behind your back. You have to, if you're going to run a seat like this, I don't care what class you're in, even if you're just bracket racing this thing, do the pour-in insert. I mean, come on, guys. That is not that expensive, and it's easy to do. And I don't care how fast your car's going. I mean, if you're going 100 miles an hour, that's damn fast to have an accident in, okay? You can get hurt going 30 miles an hour. If you're going to have this type of seat and you're just bracket racing on the weekends, or you're just out having some fun, put a pour-in insert in it. Fit it. Have somebody do it. It's not that hard to find somebody that'll do it and make it fit right to where you fit tight in the car. This is a padding backing, so this is going to have, if you watch our build series video, you'll see us measuring for this in the other car, but this is the backing plates that we're using for the ISP padding that's going to go in here. So basically this is going to be our helmet surround, and we're going to pad this thing all the way around in different thicknesses so that the driver's helmet can move slightly from side to side. So this will have real thick padding on it once it's done. We'll have a pad up here on the top, and we'll have a pour-in insert down here on the bottom. And I know what you're saying, you guys only got so much room without making major changes, but make the major changes. You can notch this seat, you can set it down farther, you can do a lot of things to gain. If you can gain an inch is a lot. If you're tight in there and you gain an inch, it's better than where you are now. it's not going to be possible to get 3 inches below your ass and 3 inches above your head. You know, there's not 6 inches just floating around in here that we have available. But do whatever you can to get the most out of it that you can get. And the more you can do, the more protected you're going to be. So don't just skimp on part of it. Say, oh, I did a pour in seat, but you know, I don't have anything up here and my head's hitting the top of the cage. Don't do that. You're still in trouble. Okay. Just half ass, and it's only going to get you half ass results when you get in an accident. Take the time, move stuff around. If the steering wheel is too close to you, move it. If you don't have a steering wheel extension, get one. Okay. We make these things so that they're easy to get in and out of the car. So this gives you 6 inches of room to get this steering column away from you when you need to get out of the car. All right. So if you don't have this, chop your steering column off, chop your shaft off, and put one of these extensions in there. If you have one of these and the steering wheel is still in the wrong spot, get a different size. You can get these in any size here and move the steering wheel where you want it so that it's comfortable to you. Make the pedals fit, make the seat fit, make the head surround fit. Make this area fit you just like a glove. You should be comfortable in your car. You should, when you're sitting in here waiting to go, you should be comfortable. You shouldn't be jammed in there and bent all out of shape, because that is not the position you want to be in if you're in an accident. Take the time to fix it. Give us a call if you need some help. Watch some of our videos. We got lots of stuff on this. We'll help you out and we'll get you the parts to do it right. Check this out. Don't blow this off. It's a lot of work, but do it. That's all I got for tonight.